Hi, this is Dan, and I am here with Ronald's play of Monster Train with the Last Divinity DLC. So we're going to do another random run. Again, unless we get something we've already won. Okay, so melting. So it looks like Exile, Melting, Exile. Exile, Umbra, Exile, Melting. This is a good combo, I think. So we'll pick our champion. Okay, I think this will be good if we can figure out a way to kill our champion. This seems pretty good. Let's go with that. Alright, getting a unit will be nice. Alright, well, these are not going to be good. Okay, so I like getting you killed, because then we can bring him back. Okay. Yeah, part of that plan involved us getting the a reform card that turn, but the deck kind of let us down. Well, there's no point in using this, because, well, maybe there is. Alright, there wasn't. If they had both hit this guy, I think it might have saved us a little bit of pyre damage. Hmm. Okay. So a little bit problem there, but overall pretty solid. Well, you are helpful. I think the only thing we want dying is going to be our champion, if and we're honestly we don't have currently the spells to make that happen. So normally I would like the draft, but I don't think I'm going to take that. Okay, well, you are interesting, except we're probably not going to go burnout. Completely sold on that being the right choice there. Let's go over here. Okay, so Harvest is a good power. We could give that to the robot. I think I'm inclined to sacrifice you into you. Okay, so then intrinsic and cheapness. This being cheap is maybe not terrible. Endless, I don't think really does anything good for us. Yeah, we need, what I'd really love is the piercing knife. I forget the exact name of a card, but the one that it does piercing damage and it increases power with each kill. So I think go up here. And honestly, we can do the same thing we did last time. We get more value out of you if you die, and then we bring you back. Okay. All right, well, you're already dying, but honestly, that's going to be even better for us. Okay. And I should be more careful, because if I can get the morsels here first, that reduces the ember drain. This is maybe interesting for our champion. It's another way to get him started. So I don't think we have anything worth duplicating right now. So maybe this. So let's go over here. Okay. Don't need you. Magic power. And piercing. If we had something that did, you know what? Planks do damage. They only do 8 damage to enemies. Still gonna do it. So Shroud Spike is awesome, especially with the robot. So I'm gonna try setting up on the middle floor. I'm still gonna do this, because I think it's working out fine. I think we want him to burn out faster. And there's no room for you guys. I guess we'll leave you in the deck. I think that was a big enough boost that it was worth not reforming our champion this turn. Hasting is a problem. Okay. There's nothing I can do about you. Okay. Yeah, that kind of sucked. The hasters are a problem for us, in my opinion. Okay, there's a lot of good stuff here. I think this really helps helps our robot strategy a lot. It'll help it get those weak units in the thing. You know what? Maybe I should have held off. Then I could have combined two robots together. That maybe would have been a better combo. Because then they would get more fuel per morsel. Because the downside would, like, it wouldn't. Yeah, they wouldn't be like twice as inert, I don't think. Oh well. Too late now. So I think just card draw is going to be fine. We have a lot of cards that give us extra space, so the faster we can cycle them, the better. I'm going to take this, and I think only that. Don't think we really need more units. I would like a unit upgrade. I want to get more multi-strike on my robot. This being cheaper would be good. It's really the. I would like card removal. But I think I care more about unit upgrades. Let's get rid of these guys because they're just gumming up the deck. I think it's unlikely they would get another. I don't know if it's just purely random or what, but it just seems like trying to fish for another multi-strike is a little bit questionable. I'm trying to think, what do I like better? Because the problem is we have no way. The buffet countdown is the problem. I mean, the 20. Because we basically get six turns with the strategy we're doing now, and that. Yeah. Let me go with you. I don't know. I wish you would just give me a direct damage spell. And turn this on. It's probably a bad idea with that other thing we just turned on. Him. First, we can do that, and that gets rid of him. Okay, that was maybe not so great. This is bad. Unless we have a way to kill those guys or win right here, we are badly screwed. It's 13 plus 8, 20. Like, yeah, I don't see a way for us to win there. I mean, I don't know. It's like, I guess it's reasonable that, like, these decks are, you know, the card I wanted is a rare card. But it's like not being able to ever get anything going is very frustrating. Cause it feels like we had something good there. It just, we weren't allowed to, you know, we were just kind of constricted, you know. It's just having to get that robot going, it's so hard. Yeah, and I think in retrospect, the idea I had later of double, you know, sacrificing a robot to the robot would have been way better. Because the harvest, I mean, it's an okay power, but it's kind of unnecessary when we have morsels. But I did think that the idea of just having our champion get killed by enemies on the first floor, I think that was sort of an innovation from my perspective. I'd never thought of that before. Normally I try to do it with my own spells, which is, you know, why I wanted the sharing knife or whatever it's called. But, you know, the bad guys can kill your champion just as easily as you can. Actually, more easily. So, so there you go. I learned something. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching, and I hope you come back next time. Bye.